My name is Martin Wasson. I'm a senior here at Barrington High School.
Hi, I'm Michael Brown. I'm a sophomore at BHS.
My name is Julia Samborski. I'm a senior here at BHS.
My name is Elena Rodriguez, and I am a senior.
We moved halfway through sophomore year.
When I was 4 years old, my father unfortunately passed away.
Art has been like a big thing for me because it's really been a place where I've been able to project a lot of my feelings, like these other aspects of myself that I'm not allowed to be, where I don't allow myself to be in the company of other people.
I was born with a rare cancer called neuroblastoma, and I was very sick for the first 10 years of my life.
For the first like month or two, I think that's like the loneliest I've ever been.
I didn't know him very well, but I knew that he was probably the best dad I could ask for. Very little memories I have of him. He was always very kind. He was always very loving. He wanted the best for me in everything I did. I remember sitting on his lap when he would drive the car and tell me I was driving, and I always thought that was really cool.
When I was 10 years old, I was really interested in animation and cartoons, not as like a productive way, but more as in like I watched them all the time.
I spent a lot of time in the hospital for chemo, tests, and many surgeries throughout my childhood.
Back in Utah, where I moved from, I used to talk to everyone. I had plenty of friends, I was happy. And then here, I couldn't get myself to talk to people. It was weird.
My mom was devastated. She was very depressed for a very long time. I personally didn't know how to deal with it. It caused me a great deal of pain. I refused help from anyone because I didn't want people to think that I was weak.
And then it culminated into me thinking, oh, hey, I could be a cartoonist, an animator. I could make stuff that I'd actually want to watch, which led to me doing like years of research on various productions.
My cancer eventually led to a very rare autoimmune condition, causing my immune system to attack my brain.
Eventually, someone invited me to try out technical theater, which is kind of like backstage crew.
What it would be like to have my own dad and how my life would be different, definitely a cause for a lot of anger I had. I was very violent for a while. As a child, I've gotten a lot of fights.
In a way, it's a lot like acting, except I have to make acting through everything. Like, it's not just character acting, but I have to figure out how the scenery works and the backgrounds and how this certain thing moves, and it just fills the world with so much life.
I started having hundreds of seizures a day by the time I was 8.
So I showed up one day, and I met Amy Jessup Tilford, who's now my boss and someone I'm really close to.
It does get better. One of the hardest things, but probably the most beneficial thing that's ever happened to me.
Through all this time, I've been able to make friends who are interested in the same stuff that I am, which has been really amazing for me, because for a long time, I've just kind of been wandering around like this little weirdo, just doing my stuff, and I love it a lot.
My doctors performed 4 major brain surgeries to stop the seizures. The surgeries were successful, and while many tasks remain hard for me, I am extraordinarily lucky because the odds have been against me my whole life.
I felt like I found a community right away. The people were just really welcoming. I felt right at home immediately. I never thought I would be a theater kid, ever. In the movies, the theater kids are always like the weirdos, but I guess they're my weirdos now.
Because of the fact that I see the damage it does when you make reckless decisions. You're not just hurting yourself, you're hurting others. You've got to look on the bright side and see that you can't really change what's happened in the past.
But it's been nice to know that if you're interested in something, there are often other people who are interested in it too. And if you do some things together, eventually you guys will just find each other.
Now I'm healthy, but the feeling of being different is still with me as I grow older.
I think in high school, the most important thing is to find your community.
If you're growing, then that's the best thing that can come from a negative experience. You can't just take all the negatives from a negative experience and wallow in them, and you can't dwell on it, because when you dwell on things of that nature, it can only bring you to a worse place than you're in.
But I have learned one thing. Everyone feels a little different, and it is okay to be who you truly are. Everyone is special, and everyone has a story.